alright, the boys to me kind of fell off with the last album, but they came back and just gave it a nice good kick. Rise and Fall, Rage and Grace from The Offspring. What's going on, ladies and gents in Cyberland? Coming back with another album review from the good old Offspring. Rise and Fall, Rage and Grace. So, after Splinter, I was just kind of like, I'm not writing this band off, but just have to wait and see what they come out with next. But I wasn't excited. Even with Can't Repeat, I was cool with it, but I wasn't like, oh, I really like this song. I was just like, eh, it's cool. And then I remember I was working at this ice cream shop in Shoreline. It was one night, and I heard the song come on, and I was like, as soon as I heard the voice, I was like, oh shoot, this is Offspring. And I was very highly impressed. And I was like, okay, the boys are back. And what it sounds like, this is going to be a better album than Splinter. Hammerhead already just got my attention real quick. And I was really looking forward to what was going to come out. But the album didn't drop for a while though, so I was kind of like, why is it taking so long? But I was very, very happy, and when the album did finally come out, I was not disappointed at all. Not disappointed at all. Loved it. Loved it from front to back. So a couple of the songs I had heard kind of live, and I was cool with what I heard. But then when I actually heard the album, I was very, very surprised. And I was very happy. I guess maybe the band, I don't know. Maybe they listened to the fans, or maybe they realized maybe what they did wrong with Splinter. I don't know. It was a huge step up for me personally. It was a lot more, I guess you could say a lot more personable, maybe. Like, I felt like Gone Away was kind of spread out throughout this album in a way. I would also say, The Noose, to me, like the lyrical connotation of Gone Away and The Noose really kind of was reflected in this album, I guess, to me at least, because I just felt elements of those songs were throughout the album, definitely. The opener, Half Truism, wasn't as abrasive as everything that came before it, but it was fine. I didn't have an issue with it. But then when Trust in You came out, I was like, oh shit! I was like, yes! And then after that, it just was like one after another. The album to me did not let up, I think, until Christy, Are You Doing Okay? And I was okay with that. I felt the way that was written was done right, as opposed to the other song. That was on Splinter. Shit, what was that song? The point is, I felt Christy, Are You Doing Okay was right. It felt right with the acoustics, as opposed to the other song that had the acoustic. It just didn't feel right to me. I felt this was fine. I enjoyed it. I felt it was a good song. Stuff Is Messed Up was cool. And Fix You was fine too. I didn't dislike anything. I just felt overall the album to me felt more meshing well with the tracks. The tracks felt fuller. The album felt fuller. It just didn't feel like Splinter, where it was just like just some tracks. Like, these songs to me felt like there was more time, I think, maybe spent into them. I don't know. But I enjoyed them extremely more than I did Splinter, for sure. My rating for this album is a 9 out of 10. I would put Rise and Fall with the Americana Conspiracy. I listened to it as much as the other work. I would say, so far, Splinter and Offspring's first album I don't listen to as much. But, well, I do listen to Splinter a good amount because it's mixed with this album when I do listen to it. But if I had to say, could I have done without Splinter? Yeah. You know, but I felt, should this have been the album that came out after Conspiracy? Yeah, I do. And some people don't like it. I hear people from time to time don't really like this album, but I enjoyed it. I liked everything about it. I liked the songs. I liked how it was written. I liked how the grooves were. I liked how the guitars were. I liked the lyrics. I feel Dexter did a really good job with it. So I was very happy with it. My top five tracks are Trusting You, Hammerhead, A Lot Like Me, You're Gonna Go Far, and Take Me Nowhere. Also, when I heard... I think when I had heard Trusting You and Half Truism, Hammerhead, and a little bit of You're Gonna Go Far, like live, like clips of it, but when I heard A Lot Like Me on this album, that to me cemented that I was going to really like this album. When I heard if that was the keyboard, I think that was a keyboard, I don't think that was a piano. The way the keyboard started the track and then Dexter kind of wallowing into it and then the guitars came in, I was just like, it's not my favorite song, but the vibe that it gives off just said, I'm going to enjoy this album. And this is when I first heard the album. I was like, I don't think I'm going to hear anything after this that I'm not going to like. I don't feel it, unlike Splinter. And I didn't. There were some songs I liked better than others, but I was not disappointed with this album at all. I just wasn't. I was very happy. It was good to hear something after what happened with Splinter. It was nice to know that, okay, they can still make some good songs. Critics may not feel the same way, but you know, I did. So, with that being said, let's cue the music.